By the way, guys, are we on the rails tonight, or I need to take some extra time? I can stretch this for 20 minutes if we need to. No? No? Okay. So, guys, this is the adventures of Skits and Happy. I knew two great gentlemen who decided to go work reconstruction after Katrina. And they're very, very interestingly shaped people. Skits stood about 7'2", and I liked it. It's rare I get to stand next to somebody who makes me feel short. And 7'2" makes me feel short, and so I'd stand next to Tim. Oops, Skits. And he'd look down at me.
Hi, you like my pink shirt?
I'm gonna tell a 7'2" guy who weighs probably about 320, works for the auto workers union, sure, whatever. Standing next to him is best friend Happy. Happy's about 6'8", maybe weighs about 120. I've never seen a real beanpole walking. It's kind of fun to see. So this ig and ook mental image decided to go out to Katrina, post-Katrina, to fix New Orleans. They do great work, they build houses, they save neighborhoods. It's quite wonderful all in all, except for one day. One day the job foreman looks at him and goes, guys, I got no work for you. Grab one of the canoes, take it out in the truck, go out on Lake Pontchartrain, have yourselves a nice day. The boys get excited, a day off. They've been on for 20 days straight, no time out of the trailer or the job site. So they throw the canoe in the back of the truck, drive out to Lake Pontchartrain, throw the canoe into the bayou, start paddling up the bayou. And it's a beautiful early spring day. Things are wonderful. The sunlight's cutting through the bayou as the mist comes down and the bugs fly across. Happy's sitting in the front of the canoe and Skits is in the back of the canoe. Happy's just wonderstruck at it all. He leans back. Skits, how you doing back there? So when he sees the canoe is about that far above the waterline, Skits is in water up to about his knees. I'm dandy, keep paddling. So they get out of the bayou and onto Lake Pontchartrain. Have you guys ever seen Lake Pontchartrain? Anybody been out to New Orleans? They got a little bridge going over it. And it's the damnedest thing. You can catch a 12-foot wave in Lake Pontchartrain. I surf, it's a thing, you can actually do it. The wind starts blowing so obscenely hard that a 12-foot swell will generate out of this freshwater, smelly fucking lake. And the boys get out of the bayou, and the options in the bayou are either we get out of the bayou with the gators or we get out of the, fuck it, surfing in a canoe! The details, the swearing, the cussing that are involved when they recanted all of this to me, I decide I'll just skip over it, and we'll say they had a doozy of a time. And they get onto the lake shore, Happy goes and gets the truck, while Skits kind of rapes the canoe, and they get back and they put the canoe in the truck and they drive back to the job site. That's when Timmy, with his like 180-pound arm, I mean, the man is like 320. I've never met somebody so large that just wasn't like massive planet size fat, but just a huge hunk of person. I mean, and I'm, again, so he picks up the canoe with one arm and throws it out of the truck and it lands on the ground and the water explodes and a plow! Job foreman looks at him and goes, what'd you get the one with the bullet holes for? I loved wrestling as a kid, and there's a wrestler named Bill Goldberg, and Goldberg would fucking rush your ass and put a shoulder into you and crush three ribs. And Timmy had a Mack freight train speed going as he started to bum rush the job foreman. That's when the universe said, wait a second. And coming off of a tree was a limb, and coming from the limb was a branch, and coming from the branch was a twig, and the twig decided to shove itself right up Tim's right nostril. Stops dead in his tracks.
I've learned something today.
Turns around and walks over to Happy. He goes, get in the fucking truck. We're driving to CVS. The gentlemen drive out to CVS. Tim has on his, we're just going with the name now. Tim has on his blue jeans and white t-shirt and a large cut on his nose. You ever cut your nose? There's a lot of little capillaries in that motherfucker. And it doesn't matter how little you cut it, you look like you murdered somebody. And so Tim walks into the only open CVS for a while. Walks in, grabs a bottle of hydrogen peroxide and a little box of Band-Aids with butterflies on them. Walks up to the counter. Thank you for choosing CVS. Oh my God!
I've had a great day.
That's it.